It has been nearly 2 years since the deadly attack at the Pulse nightclub.
All this week, special events are being held to remember and honor those affected by the 49 lives lost that day. Tonight, News 6 Adriana Ivashinsky sat down with Pulse owner Barbara Poma, looking back at these trying 2 years and the emotion just in the past 2 months.
First, there was the trial and acquittal of Noor Salman. Then there was the unveiling of the interim memorial here at Pulse. And through it all, Pulse owner Barbara Poma tells me they have been focusing on healing and moving forward.
I think it's still about healing. And I think that healing takes a really long time. And I think it really comes in small, tiny steps.
For Barbara Poma, the interim memorial is a glimpse into the healing process they've all been going through. Snapshots of the days that passed since the attack took 49 lives and how everyone involved is trying to move forward without forgetting the past.
The site is much more presentable. It's dignified, respectful. It gives you a place to have some respite time and a place to walk the property and learn and interact with it.
Barbara says she, like many others, are just handling things day by day and has been since the attack happened. And even she admits the recent trial and acquittal was a lot to deal with, but she only considers it a small chapter in her own healing journey.
And so we had to go through that chapter, and we did. And then if we just couldn't get stuck there, just like we couldn't get stuck in June 12th, we couldn't get stuck in the trial either.
Poma says she encourages people to remember exactly how they felt on June 12th and to use that feeling to continue taking action to support the families affected, whether it be through donating their time, their talents, or their money.
You know, if you forget how you felt that day, you're never going to be able to create any kind of permanent change.
And while her focus will now be on creating a permanent memorial and museum, she wants the public's focus to be on the families as they continue their own healing journey.
I think you need to be sensitive in your words, be bold in your actions, which means show up, support, be a listening ear for other people.
Reporting in Orlando, Adriana Ivashinsky, News 6.
Online, we have a page dedicated to the biographies of the 49 killed in the 2016 shooting. You can find it right now on clickorlando.com/pulsevictims.